Hello everybody, Jambo, habari yenu, Sharon aka Wabaraka here, and I am back on 10 minutes with Sharon on Real Talks. Before I get started, I just want to welcome all the new subscribers, everybody who has subscribed, thank you. If you haven't subscribed and you're watching this, please do not forget to hit that subscribe button, hit that notification bell, like and share my videos, and God is going to bless you. My channel is Sharon Wabaraka Official, and you will be a blessing as I become a blessing to you. Now, in today's 10 minutes with Sharon, I want to talk about a condition we are seeing recently quite often that is called the narcissistic personality disorder. And I want to speak about why narcissism is on the increase. Now, before we look into that, let's just pause there and ask ourselves, what is narcissistic personality disorder? As the word says, it's a disorder and therefore it is a mental health condition. But according to the English dictionary, narcissism, I'm going to read out, narcissism is an exceptional interest or admiration for oneself, especially one's physical appearance. It is self-love and often excessive self-interest in one's own comfort, importance, and abilities. So, in short, narcissism is that strong admiration that people will have for themselves. They will want to have that admiration from everybody. They would like to be in the limelight and they would like to be the center of attention. NPD is now classified in the diagnostic manual. It is a classification in the diagnostic manual. And according to Dr. Tyson Lee, he believes, or he says that the NPD is like an epidemic. You know, basically like what you are all seeing with the corona epidemic, the narcissistic or the NPD has become an epidemic because we are seeing so much of these issues. It's coming to the therapist, psychotherapist room. It's being diagnosed quite a lot by medical professionals, and so it has become like an epidemic. Now, many people who have been brought up in environments which are abusive or which are toxic, most of them do not heal. There are those who will go and heal, but most of them do not heal, and so they become abusive themselves. Now, if you've been following my talks, you will know that all my talks I concentrate on the background. So I normally go back to the roots, if you know what I mean. And therefore, even with this NPD, I will go back to childhood, because childhood experiences shape pretty much so what we become in the future as adults. And this is the same thing with NPD. With narcissistic personality disorder, research shows that the way a child has been brought has an impact or has an effect of how this child will become as an adult. So if you have lived in an environment that is toxic, if you did not experience love from your primary caregivers, that is your parents, you're going to have that low self-esteem because you have been yearning for love, you have been yearning for attention, and that wasn't given to you when you were a child. And so as you grow older, you have this competing need for attention. You have this competing need to shine, to make an impression. And that is why you are finding a lot of people who have been in an abusive childhood or who are abused as children turn out to be narcissistic when they become adults. Now, for you to know that someone is narcissistic, there are nine criteria that one has to meet so that they can be diagnosed as being narcissistic. And one of them is they've got this grand sense of, like I said, of self-importance. You know, they really feel that they are important and they should be given that attention. they got these fantasies of power. That's the second one. People who are narcissistic will have fantasy to power. They always want to be in the lead or in leadership, and have this obsession of being in power. They also believe that they are special and they are unique. Every narcissistic person believes they are special and they are unique. They don't believe anybody else is better than them. They think that they are the best and nobody else is good. Nobody else is better than them. They require this excessive admiration, and also they've got that sense of entitlement. If you don't recognize them, for example, in a meeting, they get angry. They can actually quite become aggressive about it if you don't give them that attention. So they've got that sense of entitlement of, this belongs to me. They have belief to be special. They believe to be special and unique. And again, like I said, they don't believe anyone else has the same abilities as they do. So they believe it is only them and nobody else can have that abilities. And actually, most narcissistic people, those who have done research, will tell you they are quite gifted. They can literally do anything, and that makes them use their abilities and their strengths to seek that admiration from everybody. Okay, and the other thing is they are interpersonally exploitative. This is what I was talking about. They lack empathy, and because they lack empathy, they will exploit you. When they are exploiting you, they are going to suppress you. They can be emotionally abusive as they are doing these things. And another one is they lack empathy. Like I've already said, they lack empathy. Their sense, their emotions are usually dead, so they won't really sit there and put themselves in your position to understand what you are going through when they put you through what they put you through, because they can be quite brutal when you're living with a narcissistic person. They are envious of others. You know, they don't believe, like I said, they don't believe people can be better than them. So because of that envy, and you know, envy is like witchcraft. In fact, I personally think that this is a demonic disorder. Maybe I'm the only person who will come out and stand here and say NPD is demonic, because it has all the signs of demonic issues, witchcraft. And they are also very arrogant, narcissistic people. Finally, they are arrogant, they are harsh, and they've got an attitude that is so wrong that you would want to shake them, to make them understand, do you really understand what you're making me go through? But because they lack empathy, unfortunately, they don't see that. In fact, they thrive in seeing you in pain. They thrive in seeing you down. So they'll continue to oppress and oppress until they bring you down to the level where they feel that they're going to be happy to seeing you down in that position. One of the questions that people ask is whether there is treatment for this disorder, and those who have studied, those who have done research, will tell you no, there isn't. And that is the reality, because it is a personality disorder. That means it is a mindset disorder. So ni kama their minds imechanganyishwa, you know. And for that person to actually get better, they'll have to be trained to again rethink or re-strategize their thinking. Their mindset will have to be rearranged. They'll have to be taught to rethink again. Now the problem is, when you're treating a narcissistic, because first of all, there's no medication for it, and a few people have fallen for the fact that maybe this person has severe depression. But research has shown that when you give these narcissistic people antidepressants, it does not do any good for them, because they're not depressed. You know, it's just a personality disorder. They do this, they've chosen this kind of lifestyle. They feed on seeing you down. They thrive on seeing you angry and in pain. So that cannot be treated. It can only be treated by them changing their attitude, changing their mindset, and starting to rethink. But again, what I was saying is research has shown that the many times a narcissistic person has tried to go for psychotherapy, because psychotherapy is one of the treatments, it doesn't always end well, because they will either miss appointments, come late. They believe that they don't need you. In fact, they don't believe they need any help. Now, one of the reasons that people who are narcissistic will be seeking for all this attention is because, number one, they have a low self-esteem. Any person who is arrogant, they've got this pride they cannot be told, because they don't believe they can be told by anybody. They believe in themselves, they believe they are better than anybody else, and that makes them to have that pride and to be quite arrogant. Now, so although we are seeing a lot of the NPD today, it is not a new condition. In fact, research shows that it started with the work of Sigmund Freud, as he was doing his studies on the id and the ego. So it goes way, way, way back. But why we are seeing an increase of it in today's society is what we need to ask ourselves and gain an understanding of the reason why we are seeing an increase of it. In fact, recently, a study that was conducted by Dr. Lee says that he believes this is like an epidemic. Diagnosis is coming in such huge numbers that we have to pause there and ask ourselves why. Those who have followed me and have listened to my talks, I keep saying that the pain that a child feels because of living in a toxic environment is a real pain, and so it damages that child. And when you get damaged as a child and you grow older with that pain inside of you, you will grow old as a damaged adult. And that is why we are seeing a lot of these many mental health illnesses. Now today I'm talking about the NPD, is one of those conditions that you develop because of being raised in a toxic environment. So if you are living with a person who is treating you with all those nine domains that I have given, you are living with a narcissistic person. And like I said, the reality is they may never change. That is who they are. They got damaged in childhood. And this is why I keep coming back to parenting, and I keep telling parents, if you raise damaged children, they are going to end up being damaged adults in the future. They are going to be a damaged husband for somebody, a damaged wife for somebody, but this stems from childhood. And that's the reason why I keep talking to parents. I keep bringing these issues of parenting, because a lot of the issues that happen to children when they are young shapes who they become when they become adults. So it is very important that as we raise our children, we are showing them love, we're giving them everything that they need as children, so that they can grow to be healthy adults in the future. And then you're not ending with all these issues of people who are domestic abusive perpetrators because of the experiences they had as children. So that's it for today, guys. Thank you for listening to me. Again, if you haven't subscribed to my channel, hit that subscribe button, support me, and God is going to bless you. Baraka, and I love you.